I wanted to point out a brand new learning journey that was just launched over at learning.sap.com. In this case, delivering side-by-side extensibility on SAP BTP Kima Runtime. As you know, I talk a lot about Kima and Kubernetes and open source technology within the developer news, and I point you to lots of different tutorials in the SAP tutorial system. In this case, a learning journey is kind of similar to that. What they do over at learning.sap.com with a learning journey is bundle together several different segments to teach you how to discover and learn about a different aspect of our technology. In this case, Kima, Kubernetes, containerization, a lot of the things that you need to know to actually deliver and run containerized apps on top of the business technology platform. So if you've never done this before and you've never played with Kubernetes and this technology, you might want to complete the prerequisites before diving right into this learning journey. They are listed out on the front page that I linked to in the description of this video. If you do have experience, though, and you understand Kubernetes and some of the things that go into containerization, jump right in, do all 10 steps within this learning journey, and you hopefully will have a better understanding of how Kima and Kubernetes and the business technology platform all fit together. Really happy with what the team over at learning.sap.com have delivered to our developer ecosystem. Happy coding.
Hello, everybody. This is the first time that we've ever recorded a developer news segment on an airplane at 30,000 feet going 800 kilometers an hour. But I wanted to share with you that we've started the Code Jam Roadshow. Rich and I are both on the plane, which is just a row or so in front of me. We're on our way to London to do our first Code Jam there this week. By the time the news airs, that have already taken place. So if you were in any of the cities that we're coming to in Germany and Amsterdam, the back of the U.S., as we wrap up the roadshow, we encourage you to check out the dates and times and come join us. For everybody else, we hope to do more of these events coming your way in the future, and hopefully to bring Code Jam to you in the near future. So keep an eye on the Code Jam group, and we look forward to seeing all of you developers later this evening.
This week, the new version 2.16 of the Python machine learning client for SAP HANA was released on the Python package index repository. In that release, you can find a few important enhancements, as well as some new functionality for the time series and for importing CSV files from the cloud storage locations, including SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake files. If you are still new to the Python machine learning client for SAP HANA, then we have a developer challenge for you to start with. This week's challenge is around the basics of data frames, and it is not too late to join yet. I'm looking forward to your submissions.
The SAP Code Jam Roadshow is now underway, with Tom and Rich over in the UK with the first event under their belts and about to travel over to Germany for the next one. The roadshow runs all the way through March, but that doesn't mean the end of SAP Code Jams, far from it. In fact, we are running another SAP Code Jam on Thursday, 13th of April in Eisenhagen, Germany on the BTP CLI and APIs. This is on the day before a great one-day conference that is happening on Friday, 14th of April, at the same location. That conference is BTPCon 2023 with hands-on sessions, presentations, and a chance to network with fellow SAP Business Technology Platform enthusiasts. Be sure to check out the details of the SAP Code Jam and of BTPCon 2023 in the links in the description.
Last week, you heard about the announcement of SAP DataSphere, the next generation of the SAP Data Warehouse Cloud with new capabilities for enhanced data discovery, modeling, and distribution. The new analytic model is one of the cornerstones of SAP DataSphere, in that it allows multidimensional and semantically rich analytical modeling to answer business questions easier, faster, and more efficiently. This week, the product management started a series of blog posts to bring you all the details about the rich feature set of the analytic model. You'll be able to see in details features like measure modeling, variable modeling, data preview, exception aggregation, and time dependency. The series will also focus on the benefits of analytic models comparing to analytical data sets, on the positioning regarding business layer, and the usage within SAP Analytics Cloud. A new blog post will be released every Monday in the coming weeks. So, stay tuned.